Jerome asks, what is a reasonable marketing budget in terms of percentage of gross revenue?
A reasonable marketing budget as it pertains to your gross revenue? I don't really like to stick to a number, and at my company, we don't stick to a number either. Our philosophy is that come up with the best ideas possible, right? And then find out the costs later. So when we were first starting out, we were a startup business, and I would find out things, and maybe it would cost $100,000, right? And I would bring it to my boss and I would say, this is XYZ solution for us. This is how it could work. This is the ad. This is what it's going to get us. And then I determine whether or not that it's going to bring me the ROI that I want. So the answer is it really depends, and it depends on your budget too. But we don't really limit ourselves to just a budget. I don't say like, oh, my budget doesn't let me do this, or my budget doesn't let me do that. I try to find the best ideas first and then worry about how much it costs and how much it's going to bring me afterwards. I just find that a budget really limits us.
So what I do is I look at it, I take it as a more objective approach. I don't look at percentage of sales or anything like that. What I look at is I look at how much does it cost to acquire a customer. Because if it costs you $100 to acquire a customer and each customer is worth $5,000 for you, then you can spend a lot of money, you know? So it's like, and those are really simple numbers, but like what I do for my business, for example, is I break it down. So, my biggest way that I sell stuff from myself is I have people go to a webinar and then book a call. And then on the call, we sell them something, right? So what I first look at is, okay, what is the cost to get them into a webinar? And then I look at, okay, what is the cost to book them on a call? And then what percentage of calls will actually turn into sales? And then once you have that information, then you can actually assign a budget, because once you can make it profitable, then you really don't have a marketing budget. Like at the end of the day, whoever can spend the most to acquire a customer will always win. So what you have to do is you just have to figure out what is your, you know, you've got to know your numbers. That's why it's so cheesy when they say know your numbers. Like a lot of this stuff, know your numbers, like all that stuff. I always feel like it's very cheesy, but it's super important, because if you know that it costs you, if you know that basically your profit on let's say you're an estate planning attorney and you charge $5,000 for an estate plan, but it's costing you $6,000 to acquire a customer, that's a major problem. But you know, if every lead costs you, I don't know, let's say every consultation costs you $50 and you guys close 25% of your consultations. Well, now you know that, you know, as long as you're getting consultations, then you're going to be making money. You can scale up. So I feel like I'm doing a terrible job of explaining this, but basically the gist is if you know all of your numbers, then, you know, you don't really have an advertising budget. You know, my company, like I've never actually looked at percentage of revenue compared to my marketing budget, because if your marketing actually works and you actually are paying attention to your numbers, then you can then you really don't have a marketing budget, because you should be profitable. So if you want to start small, you know, start with small tests, and I wouldn't do it as a percentage of your budget, because if you're just beginning, the budget might be a bigger percentage, or it might be a smaller percentage, just depending on how far along your law firm is. But you know, like Nick said, you might need to spend $1,000 on Google. I always say, you know, you got to spend at least $30 to $50 a day to test Facebook ads out. So if you're a firm with, you know, one client a month, that might be a significant portion of your budget compared to a firm that's getting, you know, 20 or 30 clients a month through referrals. That's not a significant portion of your budget, you know? So that's how I look at it, is I always pay attention to what's the cost per, you know, every step of the, you know, what's the cost of every step of the equation. What's the cost per lead? What's the cost per consultation? What's the cost per sale?